Statement when he says can you walk in that? The outlook of the people who are opposed to Islam is but one outlook, one orientation, and one world view. How true this statement is, when the opponents of this dynamic representation of Islam have been for the past time period of the same length of 8 years, trying with all that is at their disposal to dislodge and to undermine and to contain and to foil every step of success and victory that this Islamic revolution has gained and scored throughout these years. And in the process of their words working with their weapons, they have managed to sweep with them a good amount of non-suspecting Muslims who think or who thought, because some of them have come to realize and understand and appreciate the successes of this effort that is subject and submissive to the will of Allah. They have come to find out that all that is said and done against this effort of the committed and the devout Muslims, all that is said and done is meant to undermine and then to destroy the vestiges of this Islamic achievement. Look at the Muslims today, even after these 8 years. Some of them, and we may say, at times, many of them think that their identification with the Mujahideen in Afghanistan is to compensate for their ill interpretations and their ill feelings that are a result of the propaganda war against this Islamic revolution. They think that siding and sympathizing with the Muslim combatants in Afghanistan, that they are compensating for this feeling of theirs that takes them from one issue and that places them in the midst of another issue. And their near-sightedness cannot figure out that these two issues are not separate. These two issues are not divided. These two issues are not isolated. In fact, and in reality, these two issues are one issue in essence and in form. So when you encounter that ill-informed Muslim and he wants to support the jihad of the oppressed Muslims in Afghanistan, feel sorry for the lack of information that that person has, and then encourage him as much as you can to intensify his sympathy and his support for the Muslims in Afghanistan, because that is an indirect day could not differentiate the subtleties that are at work in this all-out war against these Muslims whose reliance is upon Allah. If these Muslims still need time to work their understanding up to the point where they can see these two issues belonging to the same source of the affair and the matter, in the meantime, tell them that they should be more enthusiastic, they should be more committed, they should be more sacrificial in their support for these oppressed mujahideen. And then when the time comes, you and they will understand that the Soviet Union and the United States, both of them are working for the same objectives, and that is to destroy this vibrant, dynamic, revolutionary understanding of Islam. But if it is a matter of time, let it be a matter of time. And this time should not erode your commitment to this all-out effort by the Muslims. Look at these 8 years, how they have unfolded. In the course of these 8 years, we have seen the ploys as they have unfolded in front of our own eyes. The interference, the instigations, the connections that a shaitan al-Akbar has with the affairs of our Muslim brothers and sisters in occupied Palestine and in Lebanon. You and I are aware of these intrigues and of these schemes, sending in their forces only to retreat and to retrieve them in humiliation and disgrace. And then later on, working through their surrogates to try to undo the Islamic growth and the Islamic maturity of these oppressed Muslims in these lands. Let us recognize, living with these events throughout these past years, let us recognize and appreciate Allah's words when He says, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَى أَنْ تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَى أَنْ تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Fighting has been prescribed for you, and it might be that you are averse to this, but it might be also that when you are averse to something, it turns out to be for your well-being. And it might be also that you like and are inclined to something else, and it turns out to be to your detriment, and Allah knows, but you do not know. At the beginning of this process, with the Muslims coming under different sources of pressures in Lebanon, we find that these sources of pressures have been for the well-being of these people, of these Muslims in that land. They fought by sending in their naval forces, by agitating their surrogates and their clients. back. It gave the Muslims more determination and more commitment. They have turned that area of the Holy Land into a military training camp for the Muslim population, for the returning Muslims in that area. The bullets, the planes, the naval vessels, the marines, and the rest of the forces that were assembled in that area did not break anyone's back. It gave more momentum and more strength to the determination of the Muslims. And year after year, the Muslims have grown harder and harder, stronger, more vibrant, and more vibrant, until today, a power of nuclear proportions and dimensions and potentials. Thanks twice before meddling with these Muslims, who throughout these years, it has been the policies of these Kafirs to make an adversity mix, to look as if it was to the detriment of the Muslims, but it was to the benefit of the Muslims. The weaklings have long departed that land. People whose aim and objective in life is finances and economics and wealth and riches and the prosperities and the American dream and the rest of these factors, they have left. And the Muslims do not need in their midst these weaklings, because the future responsibility of Islam lies upon the shoulders of those who are true to their covenant and compact and word with Allah. And see what Allah says when He has prescribed fighting for you. In the first instance, you think it is to your detriment. You think that this order from Allah is not for your well-being. And after 8 years, or in the Persian Gulf, or in the bases in the area, the common, mutual, cooperative maneuvers once between the Shaytan al-Akbar and the Egyptian government, another time between the lesser Shaytan, the Italia, other forces in the Indian Ocean or the Persian Gulf. Once again, throughout the military and air bases in the Muslim land of Turkey, moving hundreds of thousands of Russian troops on the borders in an effort to try to psychologically erode and neurologically disturb the confidence and the determination of the Muslims the public. And they have had very terrible experiences with the public because their grip is slipping over the minds of their public. They are trying to say, insinuate, that today there's a faction that is called a moderate faction that wants to reach a solution and an accommodation with the shaitan. And then not only with any shaitan, with the arch shaitan himself, they say they want you and us and everyone else to believe that this exists. They may still have influence, and they may still have a sway over some deviant and simplistic minds. But over the Muslims, the Mujahideen, the committed and the combatant Muslims, throughout these 8 years, trying with words of such nature, only once again adds to the miserable state of mind that they are in. We should be confident that no such thing exists. No one in a position of responsibility thinks that there can be an accommodation between Al-Haq and the representatives of Al-Haq on one hand, and Al-Batil and the representatives of Al-Batil on the other hand. This is totally out of the picture. And hence, right now, we understand the position that the shaitan is in. After 8 years of foreign language against the Islamic Revolution, 8 years of pronounced hostility against this new fact of life, the conduct of the shaitan has changed, and right now the shaitan wants to appear to the collective and public and general mind of the people that he is embracing the Islamic Revolution. He is arming and supporting the Islamic Revolution, a force that he has been mouthing for the past 8 years, all of a sudden, as a matter of topsy-turvy jinx magic. The Islamic Revolution. If he could not kill the credibility of the Islamic Revolution by speaking bad words and painting a bad image of this effort throughout these 8 years, today he takes on a new image and he wants to appear to the public as if he is on the side of the Islamic Revolution, embracing, downloading, approaching, being amicable and friendly and strategically considerate of the Islamic Revolution. And this is the character of the shaitan. Remember those years, don't forget, don't get a few months of the propaganda of the shaitan deceive you, because as he has changed from one image to the other, he has the ability to take on yet another image and yet another one to try to get to your evaluation of this Islamic Revolution and discredit it. Remember, throughout these 8 years, he wanted to divide the Muslims concerning this momentous act of jihad. He wanted to divide the Muslims. And everything was used in the process of trying to divide of the Muslims. As we all recall that the Muslims are forces of unity and solidarity, unification and cohesion among themselves, as they belong in a favorable position in creation, their extension with the universe, their extension into the oppressed, and their extension among the Muslims. But these powers who are on the other side are powers of division. They're powers that seek to separate and to sow the seeds of disunion among us. Not only are we on the side of Allah's regulations and creation, they are on the opposite side. They today are destroying the rules that Allah has created when He created this world and this universe. The pollution. They have polluted the air. They have polluted the water. They have polluted the mind. They have polluted the body. Laws by which it becomes a prosperous life. And we feel an affinity, a relationship to these laws, as has been previously stated. They feel that these laws have to be manipulated for their own strategic interests. Into the process of becoming all-powerful, they want to destroy the atmosphere and the environment, water and air and food and everything else, with chemicals and with other ingredients of theirs. They go ahead and do it. And if they think that to maintain their position of power, they have to divide the oppressed people, they go ahead and do it. And likewise, if they think that the only way that they can stay in this position is to divide the Muslims, they go ahead and do it. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ati'u Allaha wa rasulahu, wa la tanaza'u, fatafshalu, wa tadhhaba rihukum, wasbiru, inna Allaha ma'a as-sabirin. O you who are committed, obey Allah and His Messenger, and do not be divided or dispute among yourselves, because you will lose your drive and your momentum, and persevere, for Allah is with those who have patience. It has boomerang. They tried to divide the Muslims. And these are not Muslims who are Muslims in theory. These are not daydreaming Muslims. These are Muslims who have taken their Islam to the war fronts. These are Muslims who are committed to Islam with their lives and with their souls. And when they begin messing around with these types of Muslims, the same thoughts that they wanted to implant inside the Muslim minds and the Muslim society, they themselves are reeling under the consequences of their own thoughts and their own conspiracies. Their lives today are innumerable. Why have they negotiated or spoken to or established contact with the Muslims? Questions that haven't been... answered. If these were decent and honest people from the first days or the first weeks of this whole issue, the whole issue would have been cleared up. But because they had been lying to eternity, they had been deceiving to eternity, all of them have been involved. They want right now a process of damage control to try to minimize point five of their lies and of their conspiracies, so that when a calculated amount of truth surfaces, then the less amount of heads roll. This is the nature of those whose second nature in life is to lie, is to fabricate, is to make up events, having a dual nature and a dual character, appealing to the people with one face and then appealing to other people with another face. They cannot disguise and hide their faces and their intents from Allah. And because they are dealing with Allah throughout these years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has his way of exposing them. These are only segments and portions of the achievements of these 8 years of Islamic determination. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ خَيْرٌ إِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ أَوْ إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاهُ شَكَرْ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاهُ صَبَرْ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. The affair of the committed Muslim, all of his affair is to his benefit. If he is presented with an advantage in life, he thanks and he appreciates and he pays his gratitude to Allah, and that is best for him. And if he is inflicted with an adversity, then he is patient, and that is to his betterment. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم، وصلى الله وسلم على المبعوث خيرا ورحمة وهدى لكافة الأمم محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Islamic revolution should have years. And the Islamic revolution is not a concept as much as it is those struggling Muslims who are fighting against the Soviet Union and the United States. Both of these superpowers are involved in a war against these committed Muslims. That the past 8 years should have been enough for every sincere and every committed Muslim to recognize that there is no difference between them. Anyone, especially after 8 years of voluminous lessons, who comes to you and says that the real war is the war that is launched by the United States against the Muslims, or the real war is the one that is launched by the Soviet Union against the Muslims, is politically lacking in information, and he has not understood the position of the Kafirs and the Zalims when it comes to establishing an Islamic way of life. Today, these two forces have combined to fight against one reality, and these are these struggling and combatant committed Muslims who are there alayhi salatu wassalam referred to as Ard Khurasan. We know no geographical boundaries between ourselves as Muslims. These international territories or boundaries are a fabrication of the era of colonialism. There is no legitimacy in the Book of Allah or in the precedence of His Apostle. There is no legitimacy for these nation states. One of them called Afghanistan, another one called Iran, a third one called Iraq, a fourth one called Saudi Arabia, and on and on and on. We do not know these classifications. We know ourselves as one Muslim Ummah, and all the powers that have divided this Ummah into more than 45 different nation states, nationalities, ethnic groups, language groups, and so forth and so on. All of these powers have no legitimate argument as far as the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is concerned, and as far as the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is concerned. Today, in this war against Islam, some even Muslim, quote unquote Muslim, international boundary, an international frontier between Iran and Iraq. What does this international boundary line mean? Isn't this another concept? A concept of the mushriks and the kafirs that we today go by? Should we think in such terms? Should we accept such definitions? Or is the Muslim Ummah one Ummah with one leadership, one source of authority? We all know that that is the case. Then how do we accept the characterization of Muslims being divided along these frontiers, along these imaginary lines that should not exist in reality? But unfortunately, even after 8 years, we still continue to think that the Iraqis, as they are frequently called, are a separate people from the Iranians, which they are frequently called. And they are the separate from the Afghans, which they are frequently called. And that is not the case. They are not separate. Anyone who entertains the idea that these people are separate is only a student of Western secular national political terminology and choice of words. There is no separateness among these people. It is an imaginary separation that has gained its practical meaning by the use of force and by the client states that were established in these areas by colonialism, by imperialism, and that are today supported through their proxies that rule in these areas that want to isolate the Islamic revolution from taking its course and breaking down these frontiers, breaking down these barriers, breaking down these divisions. No, they want you to continue to think that there is no relationship between the war that exists among the committed and the activists speaking, this war between them and the Baathists in Iraq, and then the war that the Russians are involved in Afghanistan, and the military, naval, air, sea, land presence of all of these forces in the area. This is an internal affair that has to be solved by the Muslims themselves. Any respecting power in this world should move out of that area and let the Muslims solve their own problems by themselves.
توكلنا وإليك أنبنا
وإليك المصير. اللهم بك نحاول وبك نصاول وبك نقاتل.